So I want to thank you, Freedom, for messing up and coming up real good. The world be white without friends.
Amen.
These 49 years have been a ride. People didn't know that in order for Mr. Garrett to let Rocky G train me at the age of 15 when I lied and told him I was 16, I had to clean toilets. Mr. Garrett would tell me, I want you to clean the toilets, I want you to cut the grass, I want you to help Viola, that was his wife, around the station. So I had to clean bathrooms and scrub toilets, but I always wanted to be in radio. You see, when I was a small thing, my mother took me out to WP. It was on the grounds of Silas Tabernacle in a trailer. And Sugar Daddy was a very popular DJ. You could mention Sugar Daddy and the women just fall out. I mean, and so I wanted to be in radio. And so about the age of a younger age, past the age of seven. I was really younger than that, but I got a mop handle. And I had one of these record players, one of these about this big. And I pretended to be a DJ. And the first record I played, Dick Miller, was Put On Your High Heel Sneakers. Wear your, some kind of hat on your head. But that was the first one, and then it's celebrated. Leroy Garrett saw something in me, and he took a chance on me. I think, first of all, the Lord above, but I also think Mr. Garrett, and I thank Rocky G for taking the time out to train me. And the rest is history. But to be inducted into a national organization such as this is an honor. It won't swell my head any, because it's already big. But I always say, the same people that'll blow your head up,
watch it, be careful,
will blow your head off.
That's right.
So therefore, it behooves us to keep little heads and big minds. And then we'll go forward. Thank you, man. Thank you for allowing me to trick you into, and letting me train you in radio. I want to thank Gary. Gary, you are an inspiration to me. You and I go back all the way to WTAK. You are a great one then, and you're a great one now.
Amen.
And I want to thank you. And don't you ever again come up here and put hats on while you're here. you guys over here, young guys, or very, very special. I have to thank, and I'm giving my thanks here, then I'm gonna sit down. I have to thank the one who listens to me on the radio and listens to me when I'm off the radio.
Amen.
And that's the lady over there in the corner there. Can you imagine being married to an announcer? Can you hear, pretend you're at our house and just pretend that Pauline asked me to take out the trash.
Uh-oh.
Well, it's 9:30 and it's time for me to take out the trash. I love you 2 years.
Amen.
She stayed right there with me.
All right.
And I thank her for that. She knows me. My health is not all that good now. But she watches me all the time, and she knows when my sugar drops, and she knows how to get that peppermint. My granddaughter get that peppermint over there to me real fast.
Amen.
And I'm sitting over here nodding, and I have to hear Tutu talking about I'm going to sleep in the church, and I'm, she just don't know what the situation is.
Yeah, wake up.
What would leave without prayer?
Amen.
What would it be without friends who try to blow a whistle like I do every morning on that day? I think D got you beat.
D, that's
you. My mama used to come to the radio station every Wednesday. The caregiver would bring her to the radio station. Mama was with me. I took care of my mama. Marvin's Mother's Day.
She does.
And it gets hard for me because my mom and I were close. And when you in here who have moms in the land of the living, you better love her.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
You better cherish her while she's here.
Amen. Amen.
Because I'm like Shirley says, if I could mine her dreams and go and bring her back,
yes,
I would, but I can't. But Mama, she's been gone this year, be 8 years. And I miss my mom. But she would come to the station every Wednesday. They would bring her down there, and she would make her way to the door, and she said, Walter, are you there? I said, Mama, you came all the way down listening to me on the radio, and then you're going to ask me, am I here? But there was one thing that my mother would always ask me, and that I guess that hurt the most, and that I miss. Even these days now.
Yeah.
And when she got ready to leave, she would always ask me, when are you coming home? Well, I know Mama's looking down over there, and I can tell Mama, I'm coming home one day.
Jesus.
You already at home, but I'm coming home one day.
All right.
But you know, God sent people in your life.
Yes, right.
Yes, sir.
Ain't that right, Mama?
Yes, He does.
This woman took me under her wing and treat me better than she do Sherry now.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I love you. I appreciate you. Listen to this, Dale. Woman, who art thou?
Yes. Who art thou, woman? Yeah. Who art thou?
Amen. Woman, who art thou? The one that tears up the radio every Saturday.
I'm telling you,
yes.
Man. Have me shouting back here.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you for being an inspiration.
Yes. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Anointed praise.
Amen.
Pastor Bill Ford and I got in a fight over whose group there was. I want. And anointed bread is to me a group that just electrifies me when I hear them singing, and the harmony is so beautiful.
Amen.
Thank you, anointed bread, for just supporting me all these years. Thank you. Give them a big round of applause. I know what I'm going to get Brother Bobby for Christmas this year. I'm going to give him a phone that got silence on it.
All right, Bobby. It's
all right. Bobby is important. What you talking about?
Thank you, Bobby. Thank you, Mom. Yeah. We're going back on television.
Amen.
Amen.
Your video photographer is sitting right there.
Amen.
He's been doing it. I was looking at Manny, one of the videos that he did when you and I hosted on that. He's been around a long time too, ain't he?
Yeah.
Hey, amen. No. So, I didn't miss you, but Pastor Turner.
Amen.
Amen.
That one day at a time was for me.
Amen.
Amen. One day at a time. And the special thing, you know, Dr. Neville, we got in the house is a mother and a daughter look alike. Yeah. I got mixed up a minute ago. I thought that Miss Miller was the daughter. She was Miss Miller. And then I wiped off my glass and it was the other way around. and you keep on loving your mother. She sung the song, a daughter at the funeral, I won't complain, and I tell you what. I almost got up and pushed you away from that microphone. I was gonna take over. But you, everyone that made this, and Grady, I guess I worked you to death.
I don't know what you did for me today.
But Grady, you are my man. Yeah. You are. You can ask Wonder. You are my man. There is nothing that I wouldn't do for you. Because you have inspired me and you have blessed my soul.
Amen.
And the Lord is really using you.
Amen. Amen.
Keep on doing what you're doing, bro.
Amen.
Keep on doing what you're doing. And everything will be all right.
Yes,
we're getting ready to go.
All right.
Mary, if I could just touch the hem of his garment, everything will be. All right.
Amen.
I needed to hear that the other day.
Amen.
Thank you. And as I get ready to go to my seat, I want y'all to meet the lady that was responsible for me when I was, even before I got into my teens. She kept me in church. Whenever I cut up and started to do things I wasn't supposed to, she would get on me. She made me a better person. She made me. When I wanted to go out on the outside and talk to girls, she made me get back in the church because I was supposed to be there. She nurtured me from the spiritual realm. And I will never forget this lady and her husband for being so inspiring to me. She also pushed me to. I want y'all guys to give them a big round of applause. Mother Jenny Miller and Deacon Roosevelt Miller. This girl right here was a little bitty when we were in church and we came up in church together. Raise your hand, Suzette. Now, I want to thank the pastor for the use of this building and everything. He was so gracious. And
amen.
He deserves a big round of applause. Amen. A man that wanted people so cool that when he plugged in this big fan, he blew the picture off the wall. Now, get this. I want this guy to stand up when I call his name. Deacon Roosevelt Miller, will you stand up?
All right, now.
Stand up, bro.
Junior.
Yeah. Now, what y'all don't know is he's Deacon Roosevelt Miller.
Uh-huh.
And he's Deacon Roosevelt Miller.
My wife.
Mama.
But get this. He stays on North Edgemont. Where do you stay, Deacon?
North Edgemont Circle.
Man, and I tell you, and guess what? They mail get messed up too. But give those two a hand, I tell you.
Amen.
I've had a ball. I'm ready to go home. And tomorrow, we got a special Mother's Day program in the morning on the radio. Every song that I play is going to have to do with Mama. Yeah. And I don't play, I remember Mama to get people torn up. But if you listen to that song real carefully, it makes you happy because it shows that a mother knows their children. And a mother knows if their child is playing or not. And especially with the Holy Ghost. And how many of you know that a good mother these days are hard to find? Yes, they are. Because now, they don't make them like they used to. But the old mothers, they were mothers. And I'm here today, standing on women.
Me too.
Y'all might well say amen, y'all.
Amen.
Too.
Amen.
Anybody in here over 60? Over 55? You there too. So, we're ready to go. I'm happy. I pray that the Lord let me have pity. And I pray that next year I'll be here. Now, I say the best for last. The woman that's been on the telephone, the woman that's been everywhere in that Kia, driving all over the place. And remember, I want to see y'all in a Kia. And she's really did a beautiful job here tonight. Can you give a big round of applause for Sister Dee Rogan?
Amen. Yes. Amen. Amen.
And I want to thank everybody for wearing the colors. Y'all look good in blue tonight. And you just continue to wear that color well.
That's all right, y'all.
And I guarantee
you got on yellow?
Yeah.
You got on yellow, Pete.
Okay.
You got on yellow shirt and pink thing.
That's cool, too.
Okay, Mr. Brown.
Can we stand and do this again? I'm getting too many colors now. Damn it.
Yeah, Pete, you know, y'all pray for me. I need some prayer real bad. I need definitely to lay hands on me tonight. My God, you know, my wife, she got a birthday tomorrow, too.
Oh, yeah.
So it's Mother's Day and birthday for my wife. Y'all need to pray hard for Bush. My God.
Now I just want to ask a question. When you talk about laying hands on me, are you talking about healing hands or
washing hands? No, healing hands.
Oh, okay, all right. I didn't want to put the business out in the street. I didn't want to do that. Healing hands.
Amen.
Yeah. I don't want to hear tomorrow somebody call in talking about Jimmy got knocked out of it.
Oh Lord, have mercy.
We're gonna have that. Anybody else need prayer before we go?
Can I say something?
I'm sorry. Is that the mother or the daughter? What's that?
That's the mom.
Okay. Oh, okay.
That's mama.
I didn't know we had another Roosevelt Miller.
Man, this is Deacon Roosevelt Miller's wife, and she didn't know that you existed.
I was at the beauty shop one time, and I think she used to go to the beauty shop. And like Popeyes, with old Popeyes, who was there. I think he used to go to the beauty shop. I don't think he didn't know how old I did. I went in there, and she asked me my name, and everything I told her. And she said, who y'all is here? I told her, my husband.
Okay.
Said, you ain't the same lady that came in the family and said, huh? And she asked the other lady, and the other lady said, no, that ain't the same lady right there. I said, huh? I'm not the same lady. I said, I'm the only Roosevelt's little wife. You know? And I said, you ain't the same lady. I ain't gonna stop sweating in here. I told her, I said, I ain't gonna be one drink. You just let me get home, and we're gonna see who is.
Somebody be going to divorce court, huh?
Well, I tell you what, after we dismiss, we give y'all time to get together and swap driver licenses. And well, I tell you what, I love both Roosevelt. And I love both their wives. And the Millers, you are fine people. And I thank God for both of y'all.
Amen.
And it's just a coincidence. You have the same name and you have the first and last name.
In the same street.
Ain't that something? We had the same bank.
Yeah.
I went to the bank one day and so happened I had to draw some money out.
Uh-huh.
And so happened I knew the receipt. And I said, no, this ain't the right number right here. Bro, I said, well, this ain't none of your number here. And he looked at his other one, looked at him and said, no, this ain't money. I said, you know what? They done put your money in that
other man.
And they
had
for real.
Yeah. I tell you what, we're going to put this on Crime Stopper. Let me ask, as we get ready to go, seriously, is there anyone else that would like to be included in the prayer that we're closing with?
I'd like to make a request for Howard Graham's. I don't know if y'all know him.
He passed
today. You know, just pray for his family.
Amen. Amen.
He was known around. He's not from here, but it's just like his family. He's been around for a while.
Yeah.
A lot of people know him, and he's been church, you know, different churches. So we just want to keep him in prayer.
Amen.
That's
amen.
What we're supposed to do.
That's right.
Amen.
And the funny thing about it was, he was supposed to be here tonight.
Right. Sure was.
Yeah, he was. If it was God.
In the last program, I got a new video on the last program.
He was here last time.
Sure. I videoed him on the last program.
Yes, yeah, sure was.
Standing right here. Right here.
Amen. And then he got up and spoke.
Yes, sure. Yep. Sure did. Yeah.
And I want to say I've been kidding with Bobby, but we want to keep Bobby in prayer too, that he continues to make the progress that he's making.
Amen. Amen.
As well, they did surgery on your back, didn't they, Bob? Uh-huh. Yeah, they did, and they did the surgery on Sister Mary Rogers' back also. Let us keep them lifted up in prayer.
Amen.
As well, and again, we don't want to overlook anybody on.
Reverend Peter, I would like to ask. Prayer for my sister.
Oh, she did too, huh?
She have it in June.
Okay. Oh, okay, okay. All right. All right. Thank you for letting us know that. Yeah. We're gonna ask prayer also for Sister Sarah. Sarah Bones, yeah, that she will continue to progress and that she will be okay when you get back. I thank you for coming, even though they went to take her to get checked out. You still came. I thank you for doing that.
Pastor Howard Grimes, I met with his daughter and son-in-law the other day, and they're planning on having his funeral next Saturday at Royal Funeral Home. And so, yes, let's keep them all in prayer. Sister Mary, she's going through what I've already been through. We both have the rods and screws in our back, and sometimes it's real complicated. So your daughter needs some encouragement. I'm here to encourage her with her daughter. Her daughter. Your sister's getting ready to have back surgery. You know what kind it is. You know she's just okay. She's right here. No, I know. Oh, you get ready to have back surgery. Okay, okay, we'll be here. We'll definitely be praying. Amen. We got that extra stuff in our back, so prayer, but she won't have to have that. She won't. That's good. That's good. Oh, okay.
Prayer to change things.
Amen.
What made prayer strongly is that you believe in the prayer that you pray.
Amen.
All right. So to every situation that tonight is here, we just don't believe as one.
Amen.
Even before we petition God, we got to have faith even before we call His name.
Amen. Right. Yes.
We got to call it to be.
Yes.
It's already well.
Amen.
It's going to be well.
Amen.
God continue to heal the brokenness of the Grimes family. We got to believe even before it even happened.
That's right.
Yes.
Let us
yes.
pray.
Yeah.
Eternal God, we come before your presence. With thanksgiving in our heart.
Yes. Yes.
Rejoicing, knowing that God, you can do all things but fail. You said in Genesis, anything too hard for me. And Master, as we come now, Lord, you heard the different names in different situations. Lord, I can't remember each name, but I know you are God that knows everything. And Lord God, I pray that each one you camp around at bedside and whatever need you say I am, that I am.
Yes.
And we thank you are that. Father, in the hour, in the moment that they need you the most, we're grateful for your hand.
Yes.
For you said you'll never leave us nor forsake us. That you'll be right there by our side. And Master, we thank you for just being God unto them. But we pray, Father God, for the Grimes family.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Yes.
Please,
for
God.
For you have
bless
took one of your children home.
Yes, the Grimes
Lord son. God, there's someone right here, Lord, that's hurting.
In the name
yes.
of Jesus.
You say you heal the broken heart. You tend to
yes,
their wounds, Father God.
Yes,
we thank you, Father God, that you are tending to their broken
yes.
heart.
Yes.
And then, Father God, you're going to mend their wounds, Father. Sometimes it takes longer. But we're so glad you're there, Father God.
Jesus.
And Lord God, we're grateful for each and everything you've done tonight. We're grateful for 49 years, Father God.
Yes.
And Master, we look down the track for years and years more to come. We thank you for Pastor Pete.
Yes.
Thank you for anyone who has kept around and been supporting. Whatever they've done, we're grateful,
yes.
Father God. We thank you again. Now, Father God, we pray to leave from this place, but not from your presence. We thank you for traveling greatly. We always make it home safely, Father God. And Lord God, we give you all the glory.
Yes.
All the honor and praise. It's in Christ Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
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 Amen. Miss Tisdale.
We gotta get my other course over there.
Come on,
you want your
place?
Father, let it be known to our bodies.
Yeah. And then we pray that you prepare our bodies to receive it. In your precious Son Jesus' name, we pray.
I'm stronger. I'm wiser. I'm better.
Thank you. Thank you. with all of my heart, for he is great, hey, and my joy is in him. I say, glory, hallelujah, yeah, you make me want to
dance.
Oh!
Dance.
I don't believe you know what I'm talking about.
Think of you.